Wild Oats Eleven is leading the Sydney to Hobart fleet across Bass Strait, with Investec Loyal close enough to challenge the favourite. But rough conditions overnight forced contender Wild Thing to retire from the race.
Five-time line honours winner Wild Oats Eleven dominated in the testing overnight conditions, a 30 knots southerly pounding the fleet. By daybreak, the first retirement, Celestial, forced to turn around.
We got hit by the front, which we expected. You could see it. There's a massive roll cloud. It was an amazing cloud formation, actually. It was quite dramatic. There's fitting break on the boat, the gooseneck, and that was it. Game over.
As the afternoon arrived, the race favourite was extending its lead as the Maxis entered Bass Strait. The celebrities stocked Investec Loyal just behind and staying in touch.
We're inside of the Oats, which is very encouraging, and we've hung with her all night.
2003 winner Wild Thing hung on to third place during the rough night of sailing, but has been forced to pull out with sail damage and is now returning to Sydney. Accenture, Yeah Baby and Duende are also making the return trip.
If you were looking for a silver lining from those boats forced from the race today, it would be this. The southerly conditions that have caused all of their problems should actually make the trip back up the coast to Sydney a little bit easier. But I don't know how thankful the retiring skippers will actually be.
Winds are expected to die off as the front runners cross Bass Strait, making for a high-tech battle of skill between the crews.
It's going to be a really, really tough night because we have a very, very tough patch of light wind to fight our way through to get to the Tasmanian coast.
On the New South Wales south coast, Lachlan Kennedy, 10 News.